Hello, my name is Dr. Sanjay Govil. I am a senior consultant in hepatobiliary surgery and liver transplantation at the Manipal Hospitals, Bangalore. So donor liver matching is actually a very simple process. It's not like a kidney match. All we need is that the blood groups need to be compatible. So if you can get blood from your donor, you can get a liver from your donor. So they have to be either the same blood group or they have to be O blood group, which is a universal donor. We don't need any stronger matching than that. Chances of rejection. There is a condition called acute rejection, which is the most common type of rejection that occurs in approximately 30% of patients who undergo a transplant, but it is in the early weeks after transplant, and it is the normal process of the body's, the recipient's immunity, the patient's immunity adjusting to the new liver. And it just means that we have to treat these acute rejections. It's rare for an acute rejection to cause any kind of a serious complication. Chronic rejection is something that occurs over years, but it causes significant damage to the graft in a very, very small proportion of patients, maybe about 5% of patients. And therefore, it's not usually a big worry as long as patients are taking their medication appropriately and are being looked after properly by their physicians. In a rare, some patients, it can still occur despite everyone's best efforts, but the chances of that are very little. Actually, more than rejection, patients who have had a transplant, they tend to become obese, develop blood pressure, diabetes, heart disease, and these are things which also need monitoring, and they constitute a bigger problem really in some patients who are not careful with their diet and exercise after transplant, are more likely to cause problems than rejection.